So this session will be about oscillators, the new chapter, oscillators. Oscillator is nothing but an electronic device or a circuit, electronic circuit that generates these oscillations. Oscillation means what? These sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal oscillations, that is AC waveforms, they are called as oscillation. Electronic circuit that produces such oscillations are called as oscillator. In other words, they take DC energy and convert it into AC energy. So another definition is they convert DC energy into AC energy. They are also called as a oscillator. And depending on whether sinusoidal oscillations are created, they are called as, they classified as sinusoidal oscillator and non-sinusoidal oscillator. And based on the components that is used in that circuit, if L and C, L means what? Inductor. C means capacitor. If L and C components are used, then they are called as LC oscillator. If resistor and capacitor are used, then they are called as RC oscillator. And there are another type of oscillator called as crystal oscillators. Here they use the crystals, piezoelectric crystals, the crystal which demonstrate piezoelectricity. We will study about it. They are called as crystal oscillators. So these are the classifications or the types of oscillators. Now these oscillations, when it comes to oscillations, it can be either sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal, I said. In this non-sinusoidal, we have different types of waveforms. See, this is a square wave. This also is an oscillation, but it is square type. This is a rectangular wave, triangular wave and sawtooth wave. So these are the different types of non-sinusoidal oscillations. Depending on how the energy is sustained, your oscillations is also classified as damped oscillations and undamped oscillations. As you can see here, as the time passes, the intensity or the magnitude of the AC waveform is dropping. This is called as damped oscillation. And here you can see that the energy is sustained throughout. This is called as undamped oscillation. So this, in this type of damped oscillation, there is a lot of loss of energy which is not feasible, which is not required. What we want is proper undamped oscillation to be generated. So for this, the oscillator uses positive feedback. So in the next session, we will see what is the basic principle of the oscillator. As you can see, there is a basic amplifier and a feedback network, but here we'll be providing a positive feedback.